Hi, I'm John Cardwell, pastor of Sovereign Grace Baptist Church in Anniston, Alabama, and the author of Christ and Him Crucified, as well as a Puritan family devotional. Now, a Puritan family devotional is going to be free on August 11th for free download on Amazon Kindle. Same as what we did for Christ and Him Crucified, the King James Version is anyway. It will be absolutely free for 24 hours beginning August 11th at midnight and going to 11:59 on August 11th. So Saturday from Friday night, you can get it from Pacific Standard Time until Pacific Standard Time, 11:59 p.m. For download at Amazon Kindle, 11:59 p.m. on the 11th of August. I'd like to say a few things about a Puritan family devotional. Though it is a small book as far as the paperback, and it's very convenient for us because it's about the size of, say, smaller than the size of my Bible here, and being able to carry it along with me, put it in my backpack or what have you, and we utilize it at home, it's more than just a collection and a compilation. This is a resource that we wanted to make available in the homes in Alaska, and it is not a devotional as you would find other devotionals like Morning and Evening by Mr. Spurgeon, wonderful devotion. Faith's Checkbook, again, by Mr. Spurgeon. My Utmost for His Highest, excellent devotional glean a lot of insights from that, but it's not a speaking of a passage of scripture throughout a year. What's different about this is by utilizing first the Robert Murray McShane reading plan, it provides for reading through the Bible and making this the Word of God your immediate possession in each one of your devotionals. It has for morning and evening both secret or family devotions, four portions per day that allow you to read through the Old Testament once in the year and the Psalms and the New Testament twice within the year. So in a year's time you have four portions that bring to you the scriptures. And as John chapter 17 and verse 17, as the Lord Jesus prayed that high priestly prayer on the night he was betrayed, he said, "Sanctify them through thy truth. Thy word is truth." And this is what is important about this particular devotional, different from those other devotionals, and by all means use those. But if you're not reading the Word of God daily, and you're not gleaning from the truths of the Word of God, then you will certainly be lacking. There is also the introduction to Robert Murray McShane's reading portions in that, which we read as a family every once in a while to remind ourselves of the advantages and the dangers of reading through the scriptures so systematically. We don't want to get puffed up in pride because I've read my portion and get to a legalism, but we do not want to forsake it either. There are advantages to being able to have the Word of God as daily bread for your soul. Puritan's Catechism, which is a compilation of the Baptist Catechism and the Westminster Catechism, put together by Charles Spurgeon and making it available for his congregation over 150 years ago, 160 years ago, we've put that together too. And what we do in our family is we read the portion after beginning, starting with prayer, and then we go into the catechism. The catechism in recitation allows us not only to take these primary and fundamental truths of the Bible and of our salvation, but in recitation, the memorization comes forth from it, and also it allows us to be in one accord, to have our hearts and our minds prepared to where we go to the scriptures. And so we actually do that at the beginning. But you can, you know, the suggestions are in there with this little 100-page devotional that has these things in them. There's also the the 1689 London Baptist Confession, that in breaking it up into its various segments and various parts, you can read the each chapter and read it together, and that those truths as a systematic theology will allow you to grow in the doctrines of the truths of the Bible as they pertain to our salvation, and seeing Christ exalted in it and his substitutionary atoning death, that excellent, most excellent work of the Lord. And then finally, it ends with having 14 hymns and psalms, seven psalms from the Scottish Psalter, and also seven hymns, the more famous hymns like Augustus Toplady's Rock of Ages and Amazing Grace by John Newton and so forth. We have some of those hymns at the end so that you might lift up praises in worship unto God in your family time or in your private devotional, having it all in one collection. We also have a Pilgrim's Family Devotional, which is made up of the 1742 Philadelphia Baptist Confession. It is not currently on Kindle, but I'm hoping that they will be up on Kindle very, very, very soon. Hopefully, I'd like to have them up by the time this starts, where the King James Version is free, and that you'll have all the versions up there. Right now we only have the King James Version up, but I'm hoping that all four of the four main versions, ESV, NASB, and New King James Version, along with the King James Version, will be up, but the King James Version will be free on the 11th of August. So I want to encourage you with that. Go ahead and stay with your other devotionals, but if you're not reading the Word of God daily, which this devotional helps to encourage, I encourage you to be in the Word daily. It is in the Word that is sown in our hearts, that speak of the Word that was crucified for our salvation, for our souls. So remember, Christ Jesus paid a debt he did not owe. We owe a debt we could not possibly pay. Christ and Him crucified is the sum of the gospel, and I hope you enjoy the books. If you do enjoy it, please write a sentence or two in the reviews for Amazon.com if you're using it, if it's been a blessing to you. So enjoy, and may the Lord bless and keep you.